Okay, so we're making sweet potato flatbreads.
Ah, yeah.
And they just have two ingredients, but I add three because I like nigella seeds. But you can leave those out. So what you do first is you steam your sweet potatoes with the skin on, and then you just peel the skin off. The sweet potatoes need to be hot when they mix with the flour to make the flatbreads, otherwise it doesn't work. So this is pretty hot, they've just come out the steamer now. You have to steam them really because it keeps them moist, otherwise if you put them in the oven and stuff, they're just not moist enough and it won't bind properly with the flour. I'm just peeling these. It's got funny knobbly. Mash them up.
Yummy.
Okay, so I'm going to need this cup to measure. So in a bowl, put one cup of all purpose flour. This is just organic plain. Put that in there. And then this into the cup so we can measure. So it's one cup of flour to one cup of sweet potato. Nice and easy. I've got a couple more sweet potatoes here just in case I need to make up some more. Yeah, it's made half a cup with a medium sized. If you usually have a really large one, it'll be alright. You can also use the white sweet potatoes, not just the orange ones. But I think these have got like more nutrients in because they're like orange. Bit of an A.
I can't remember the white sweet potatoes taste like them. They're the same.
I've never tried them, I don't think. Don't usually find them in this country.
Okay, so if anybody knows any different, just let us know.
I'm going to just do this other one as well. Can we just do half? What are you laughing at?
It's just how you squished it, it came out of them. It's the simple things that amuse me.
We're at one cup, lovely. You can use him for something else later. So like I said before, I like to put nigella seeds in because these are the seeds that they put in naan breads at the Indian. So you put those in now if you want to use them. If you don't bother. They smell amazing. Sorry. There's about a teaspoon in there. We just add those two ingredients together now.
together now. So just put a little bit of the flour down, not too much. Don't waste any. How much will you usually make? 8 or 6?
I can't remember. Go for 6 now.
Six might be too big.
No such thing. Sizes in this family.
So I'm not very good at rolling out these round, but I don't think it really matters. Small, so I reckon we should go for just 4.
Candy.
Should we do little ones?
Yeah, Phoebe's alright with little ones.
Can you know what they are?
Sweet potato wraps.
No, I'm going to go for 4 big ones. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to put sausages on them. Vegan sausages, by the way. Behind me, I've got one of these iron pan things. What are they called? Skillet? No.
Oh, no idea.
Plate. Just a plate that I put on the electric oven. And that will cook it off. I think you can do it in a pan. I don't think you need any oil.
Just a hot plate, isn't it?
The other one ready to go and put on. smoky in here. Pan was a little bit hot. Make sure it's not too hot.
That's alright.
You can have that one then.
That's the flavour, isn't it?
So they don't take long, you just got to keep an eye on them and flip them.
Well, there's nothing really can be undercooked in this, is it? I mean, it's a sweet potato, it's already been steamed, so it's already edible, all flour. Good thing about vegan cooking, you don't usually get poorly from it.
These are Linda McCarthy sausages over here to go in them afterwards.
Sausages.
That's what they should look like.
Looks good.
There we go. All done.
Lovely.
Bye.